I have another special guest here with me, one of my favorites in the Nollywood industry, a brother and an amazing actor, Timini Egbusan. What's up?
I'm good. Finally, I made it.
Took you long enough to be here.
I know. Thank you. Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
Yeah. First of all, congratulations. Just got nominated in the Best Actor category drama.
Yes.
For the African Magic Viewers Choice Awards. Where were you when you heard? Were you watching? You had to be watching.
So true story, right? When I was expecting this one. Like, this is not one of them ones. Every year, I do good work, and I feel like the work should be recognized. And then I don't get nominated, and I'm like, all these people, they don't give themselves the award. Yeah. You know? But this time around, I felt like, especially because of the Future Awards, because I won the Future Awards Prize in Acting.
Yeah. Congratulations.
For 2019, if I do say so. You know? And then I did that. So this particular time around, I was really expecting this nomination. So
why? Besides the Future Awards? Was it how good you think you did?
I feel like Elevator Baby was... I gave my blood, do you understand? I literally gave my blood for that film. And I felt like people actually started to really recognize me as not a fine boy actor and actually a deep actor. So I expected to be nominated. Yeah. I made sure that they submitted, you know, because as the producers have to submit. So I made sure that they submitted and, you know, I was definitely expecting it. It was also one of the best performances acting-wise from any male actor in the year in review. Like, this is not even me
very
saying,
modest.
No, yeah, no, it's true. Like, I'm saying, like, you know, if you really check it, you know, the other people that I was expecting as well. So I kind of like did the prediction. We all do predictions for Oscars and all that. And I knew that Timini's name would pop up. Yeah. So when I heard Timini, you know, the first thing I did, I was home. I didn't want to see to watch it with anybody in case, you know, when in case I didn't hear my name.
So that you can cover your shame quietly.
So I had to just quickly, when I heard my name, I called Akori first things first, you know. And we were excited together because...
You mentioned something there, and did it bother you? Because, I mean, you seem to get typecast at some point where you were. It was the fine boy, either playing a girl or being in love with a girl. That seemed to be Timini. Was that bothering you at some point?
You know, to be fair, because it never really bothered me because I understood that, like, it's all the journey, right? Yeah. You know, if at first it was Dakore's brother, I enjoy that, you know. And then I started getting roles, I started getting opportunities to actually lead films and all of that. And I enjoyed that as well. You know, so there's no problem. You know, I'm getting work, I'm getting paid, I'm showing that I can act. Somebody needs to play the fine boy, it's fine, you know. And that now makes it even better when I now surprise them with a role like the elevator baby character, you know.
You're up against some pretty interesting people.
Yeah.
Gabriel Afolayan for Coming from Insanity. Yeah. Swanky for Living in Bondage, which was absolutely amazing. Effa, who killed it in Seven.
My boy.
Ramsey Noah, the legend.
Daddy.
For Levi. So these are quite impressive performances this year. How confident are you feeling?
Okay,
or are you one of those who is great enough to be nominated? I know you're not.
Yeah. I'm not going to lie. I'm going to climb that stage. You understand? I feel like, you know, first of all, I'm excited that it's a voting category. Right? Not all the categories are voting categories. Yeah. Some of these categories, the judges, the jury pick, you know. So, yes, it's down to the fan base. And that's why I'm not even trying to be humble about it. I'm begging my fans. I'm letting them know that you guys need to vote for me. Because guess what? This is not one of those we're all winners. I want to win, you know. It's giving me, like, a nice push to even do better, you know, to even do more. So, I'm not really... I mean, all of them are fantastic actors. Efa is my guy. Ramsey is like an Egbon to me. Jiget. Swanky, I've never met him, but he actually killed it in Living in Bondage. No doubt about that. Gabriel Afolayan, too, has been killing it consistently, you know, over the years. So it's down to our fans. We're all good. Do you understand? It's down to our fans.
And you think that's a fair way of judging?
I feel like, first of all, you know, when you pick out five amazing performances, you know, it's, the jury said it. They were looking for extraordinary, they were looking for special, and they've done that. I feel like they've done their part. It's a Viewer's Choice Award. That's what it's called, right? Uh-huh. So allow the viewers to choose. A lot of people might, I mean, Ramsey might have more fans than me, you know, Gabriel. You know, a lot of them, maybe some of them might have more fans than me. But it's like, it's about the push, you know, and it's about how much you want it. I really want it. I'm constantly voting. And it's one of those things where, like, I mean, if I don't win, it doesn't stop me. I've been in this industry for 10 years. I just started getting recognized properly in terms of awards and all of that, like, maybe 2 years ago. But that didn't stop me because my journey is different, you know. We're all, and that's why I also say that I have no competition because if you really gauge it, what I'm trying to do is way different from what anybody else is trying to do.
Which is what exactly?
Me, I'm just trying to enjoy it. I feel like talent-wise, I feel like God blessed me in different ways. And I feel like I cannot allow it die inside of me. So as long as I can make money, I can pay my rent, I can live the life that I want, and I can still do what I like to do. Be it singing, be it being creative, be it influencing, acting, management, whatever it is that I can do, however it is that I can plant myself, I feel like, yes, Nigeria has a lot of natural resources, you know, special natural resources. I believe that I am one. And I have to now cultivate that so that maybe, you know, eventually, sooner or later, I will be able to take Nigeria, take Africa to the world and actually show talent.
Go. Well, you kind of started off on TV.
Yes.
Before crossing over into film, you did MTV Sugar. Mm-hmm. You were briefly on Tinsel, I believe.
Yes, Tinsel.
Was it a hard transition going into film from that?
No, so because
TV actors sort of stay on TV because it takes your time. Sometimes the pay is not too bad. You know, how was the transition?
So what happens is, you know, because obviously Dakori being my mentor and all of that, I before I started acting, I really studied the industry. And what I knew that I wanted to do for a fact was do everything. You know, I wanted to do TV. I wanted to do Iroko. I wanted to do Africa Magic Projects. I wanted to make sure that I did everything so that I'm showing myself to all platforms possible. So yes, TV was the easiest way to start. I started on Tinsel. Barely had anything to say for, you know, just a guy. My guys would call me and say, why, we're watching you, why? Are you gonna talk? I'm like, guy, I beg, just leave me first, you know? But it wasn't really hard because people now started to notice. It's, the thing about my journey is the director, Stokpe Oshin, was a director on Tinsel. I barely had lines, but she saw something, you know. And then when it was time to cast for MTV Sugar, she called me for the closed audition, you know. So it's all about the journey. That's why I tell people, all of these young guys, a lot of people want to just blow. Like, they just want to blow. You've started acting for 2 years, you're already frustrated. It doesn't work that way. People are watching, and your character also says a lot, you know. So you might not see me work, but you might see my energy, and you might just want to have me on your set when next you're shooting. That's all it is, you know. So it started from that. Elevator Baby is actually not my first lead in a cinema film. There was a movie I did called Ajuaya. The budget wasn't as big. Maybe people didn't hear about it as much, but I feel like everything is connected. If I show my journey to Skinny Girl in Transit, which is a web series, everything is kind of really connected, and it's all about like just placing yourself there.
You've talked a lot about Dakore, who's obviously your other sister and is an icon in the industry. Yeah. She's been in this game for quite a while. Mm. She obviously, I don't want to use the word paved the way, because paved the way has been trending.
It's causing trouble.
On social media recently. But is it a blessing or a burden having that tag with you? Because, I mean, I know you appreciate the fact that she's, you know, she held your arm, she took you through into the industry and all of that. But has it ever been a problem where it's like, oh, you are Dakore's brother?
No, it hasn't. I feel like, you know, the glass is either half full or half empty. I've definitely looked at it as a blessing, you know. So people might have things to say, but I feel like a lot of people listen to me at the beginning when, you know, oh, Dakore's brother, you know, nice, but you're not going to have a 60 million naira budget film and put somebody because it's somebody else's, as in, what's happened, do you understand? I feel like it doesn't work that way. It made some extra eyes look at me, but now I meet people that know me, and then through me, they find out about Dakore, you know. Everything is getting so diverse, so there's really no box out. We now have some sort of like friendship where we're helping each other. Where she's coming from, 23 or 24 years in industry, obviously there was a way they did things, there's discipline that she distilled in me, and there's also like social media savviness that I have, and just how to just work the social media space, and just how to work the audience, you know, which I'm also teaching her, you know. So it's kind of thing like we're both learning from each other, and it has never really been a problem, you know. Both of us, she's doing like this year now, her film she was in got nominated, but she didn't get nominated personally. But the Egusin name is still going, you know. Yeah. That's the best way to look at it. It's not a thing where, oh my God, you know. At first, when I first started, I'll take pictures and then pictures will come out and they'll just say, Dakore's brother, they won't put my name. They just say, Dakore's brother in new photos. I'm like, wow, I have a name, you know. But I feel like, you know, things have changed now. Every time we say, I'm sure there are people watching this interview saying, oh my God, they're related, you know. So that shows you that it's not really about that, you know.
So it would never be a problem?
I don't think it'd ever be a problem. Yeah. I'll probably be acting more longer than she, when she even stops, you know. So it would never be a problem.
Was it ever a problem with family, though, that one person is doing it and you are going down the same route?
So actually, I didn't tell her when I wanted to start acting. I didn't tell anybody. I studied psychology, graduated, got a 9-to-5 sales and marketing in an e-commerce company. And then I just heard about the audition. And what I like to do is I like to just do things. Sometimes talking about it, you know, you get people to talk you out of it.
Yeah.
So I just went for the audition. And there were like 4,000 people in the audition. I got the role. And then I told her, oh, I was like, to me, there's no money in this industry. You know, because that was her advice, because she knew that I like the finer things of life. And she said, you know what, Timmy, there's no money in this industry. I'm not going to lie to you. You have to find a way. If you want to do it as a hobby, do it as a hobby. Find somewhere else so that you can actually
make money.
And I took that and I've really, really gone with that in terms of like the way I even up until now, I'm not only an actor, you know, I'm working with a lot of brands in terms of social media, content creation, you know, in terms of ambassadorship, in terms of like just being present, you know. And that's a mistake that a lot of other actors make, you know. I feel like they just really focus on acting and really focus on the work. And I get it that you're passionate, but you kind of also need to now try and make yourself into a marketable brand. Look at Ebuka, for example.
We're talking about you, yeah. But is that still the case, though, with money back? And I like to ask this question whenever I have people from Nollywood here, because it's why a lot of people seem to jump into production.
Yeah.
Is that still the case with regards to how much has been made? And then why do people still do it? What's driving you to still do it?
I feel like anybody that is doing Nollywood is that's why on Instagram, when I'm on set at 4 a.m., I make sure I show it. I let people know, like, if you don't love it, you won't be able to be in the industry. It's not as nice to the point where you're just in it for the money. But I also feel like it's also a misconception and it's also a misrepresentation of the facts. There is money in Nollywood, you know. We're getting paid. We're not getting paid as much. Yes, we're not getting royalties. We're not getting a few things back, you know, but there's money. If you check it, you're shooting a movie for 6 days, you're getting XYZ. If you're applying yourself and you're working maybe 3 times in a month, maybe 2 times in a month, you're probably already making more than the average banker or the average lawyer or the average, you know, person in a 9-to-5. You know, so let's not make it seem like it's so bad. And also, let's also try and like, also, it's showbiz, you know. Yeah. Everybody comes on interviews and says, ah, there's no bad. It's not as bad. Yeah. It can be better, yes, but it's not as bad. Maybe I'm talking from a privileged place because I've been lucky to work on some good projects, MTV Sugars, you know, Skinny Girl in Transit. These people pay, it's not Hollywood dollars, you know, but it's not bad. And I feel like it's a misconception.
There's sometimes not a complete synergy with, I don't like to use the word old Nollywood, but, you know, the Nollywood, they seem to be a new guard that took over a lot of, you know, productions and stuff like that in the last couple of years. And I've heard a few complaints, even in the media, from people from the 90s, you know, Nollywood back then, saying a lot of you these days get carried away. You know, you come in and all you do is post on social media. Mm. You spend half your time on sets, you know, making videos and not focusing on being actual actors. Do you think that's the case where newer actors in the scene are more carried away by the fame than the craft?
Fact. I feel like there's definitely truth to that. But I feel like there's also a problem in this whole segregation of old and new. Like, we all need to, these old guys need to check and see what these new guys are doing and try and see how they can adapt and learn from it. Every time I'm opportunity to work on a set with like
a veteran,
you know, it's so much of a learning process. Sometimes you watch how they do their lines, how they get into character, how they, you know, they learn and then they also see me do social media and they're like, you have to let them know you're working now so that, you know, they know that you're in demand and then they can now think about you in a certain light. You know, they're like, it's true, I'll never have thought about it, you know. But when you come from a bitter place, you don't see the good in anything that anybody else is doing. You're just looking at it as, wow, you know. I talk to people, they say, XYZ gets this role because he has 400,000 followers. I try to explain to them that I don't have 400,000 followers. I have less. I'm also looking at someone there's people that I have more followers than. There are people that have more followers than me. Am I going to fight with people that have more followers, even in terms of influencing? I wouldn't. My own thing is to just try and make sure that I say, okay, how did they do this follower thing now? So that I can also, you know, build it. You know, brand, it's a business, whether you like it or not. When producers want to put people in the movies, they want to put people that can help to the sales, you know, you're not going to fault them for that.
Yeah.
Yes, they might put one or two people that are really true to the craft, or one or people, but like, if I'm a producer, I would look for an actor that has some sort of extra value that he's bringing to the project
besides just the act.
And it's not like as if everybody that has value doesn't know how to act. There's a mix of it, you know. See this list that we're talking about in terms of nominations. Everybody understands the value of social media, you know. So let's not look at it as a fight.
Are there roles you won't take?
Yeah, I feel like a few roles have come to me and I just feel like it's not the time or the budget is not enough, you know, and then you now make it, you know, like, there's a role that came to me last 2 years talking about the guy was a homosexual. And the platform that he wanted to put the show on, the budget that he wanted to use to produce it, I knew that it wouldn't have probably been shot well it wouldn't have probably been pushed well. And it wouldn't have probably been, the story wouldn't have been told well, then it just ended up looking like a joke, you know. So I feel like, yes, there's a time for every type of role.
Will you most likely do anything?
I'm really true to the craft, like, at the end of the day. And when I go into the character, I really forget about Timini, you know. And, that's what you're supposed to do, right? Bring light to a certain area that, you know, people have probably not seen.
Yeah.
And just do justice to the character. And that's what I try to do when I get into a role.
You've been on TV movies with some pretty impressive it girls in the industry. And that always comes up. There's always, is this the girl now? Mm. Is this who he's dating? Mm. Are you single, first of all?
No, I'm not, actually.
Okay, you're in a relationship?
Yeah, I'm in a relationship.
Damn it! I just heard hearts breaking. Is she in the industry?
No, she's not.
Okay, how long has this been for?
Sir?
How long has this relationship been
Hello?
For?
Hello? I feel like I've told you enough already, you know. But like, yeah, I'm definitely in a relationship, you know. And it's early, you know. We're still just looking at it, okay, and trying to grow and trying to learn about each other. You know, the mistake is that, you know, people understand that the career is one thing, but also it gets lonely, you know. You get, you know, you need that love, you need that support, you need that, you know, affection.
How does she feel about your roles?
She understands. But like, I feel like we're still trying to, you know, because, you know, everybody needs to be comfortable. That's the thing about marriage. When you go into marriage and when you go into all those type of stages,
we're talking marriage, right?
You don't want to act. No. That's too far away. You know, but I'm saying, like, you don't want to act like you're comfortable. You need to be truly comfortable with this person. I'm like, guy, yesterday I posted something on my story as some film I did. There was some really passionate kissing in it. And I was like, she was like. I'm like, yo, I kiss you different.
Is it harder because she's not in the industry, so for her to understand?
She's actually very intelligent. She's very enlightened. So it's not really about, I feel like she understands that it's work and she understands that that's what's bringing food to the table.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very impressive. Okay, well, 2020, what's coming? What's coming?
Guy, I don't even know. You know, 2019 was such an amazing year and I was really afraid for 2020 going in because, you know, when you have a good year, you're like, God, how am I going to top this? And when I now look back, I realized that in 2019, I didn't have a plan. That was the first year that I actually didn't have a plan. That was the first year that I said,
things just happened.
Yeah, like, I was just like, you know what, guy, just be ready, you know. So 2020, I'm going in with that same ginger, you know, just staying ready. I have a few scripts that I'm already working on. I've shot like 2 projects already. And I'm looking forward to that call from my people in Hollywood.
Young girl. You also mentioned singing there a bit. Are you considering that?
You might be shocked. Those guys are making money. See the money they make. See the money they make in December. Please. But I mean, I feel like, I'm definitely, there's a film that I've done. I've done 2 films that I actually had to sing in.
Okay.
And my voice is not that bad. You know, so why not, you know?
Are you actively pursuing it yet?
No, not yet.
Or you're just
creating music for a film that I'm working on. So in the process of creating music for the character, you know, I'm voicing it. So if it comes out and I give it to a few people that I trust their opinions, and they say it sounds good, because that's another mistake people make. people that are just gassing you around. People don't really give you their honest opinions. So, like, if I give these people that are in my close circle and they say, guy, really, Sam, why not?
All right. Congratulations once again on
Thank
the Future
you so
Award.
Much. Thank you so
and
much.
Congratulations on the Africa Magic Viewers Choice Awards
Thank
nomination.
So
good luck. It's a voting category, so if you think...
Yes, please.
You might want to support him. And all the best, man.
Thank you so much,
Ebuka.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate this.
I appreciate you for coming,
Take
man.
It easy. Don't just stand there teasing me.